Hi guys, welcome back to today's video. We introduced the excellent ZIKE MagSafe wireless charging stand with an active cooling system a few months ago. It's designed to generate a strong wind to take out the heat while charging. There is a Made for MagSafe logo on the package. You can click the upper right corner to check that article. And now we've received it and are going to test the charging performance to see if this system can affect charging. The charger included in the package adopts a replaceable two-prong design, and you can replace different plugs from different countries and regions with a single twist. And the upper power can be up to 45 watts. This is the band output DC adapter. Next, let's get back to the charging stand. It's divided into three parts, the MagSafe charging module, the stand, and the wireless charging module. The wireless charging module on the bottom is covered with flannel with a comfortable feel. So when you use it to charge the AirPods, the soft material will not leave scratches on this kind of plastic product. Here is an LED indicator light, and there is a fan switch in the corner which can control the active cooling system. The MagSafe charging module is from Apple Official with a gray active cooling module on the back. The turbocharged active cooling fan inside can generate a strong wind to take out the heat. You can adjust this angle up or down to get the best viewing experience, and the adjustment range can be up to 40 degrees. There is some specs info on the bottom of the base, Modlis Z557. It can support DC input of 15 volts, 3A, and the MagSafe and wireless charging module can output up to 15 watts and 10 watts respectively. It has passed CE, FCC certifications. The band DC adapter can easily fit into this hidden slot, which makes it look like a building cable design. We tested four iPhones from 6.7 inches Pro Max to 5.4 inches Mini, and they can charge with no problem. Only the distance between the 14 Pro camera part and the charging module is pretty narrow. The heaviest Pro Max can be firmly attached to it, so you don't need to worry about potential drops. Then let's take a look at the charging performance. The power meter shows that the no load power consumption is about 0.5 watts. Please note that the measured power for wireless charging is higher than the actual power received by the electronic product. When using the top MagSafe charging module, the power is close to 23 watts. Moving on to this wireless charging module, it can provide almost 2 watts for AirPods. Next, let's check out mobile phones. The charging power for iPhone 14 Pro is stable at around 8 watts, and it can provide more than 10 watts for Android phones like Xiaomi, Huawei, and Samsung. Next, let's charge two devices simultaneously. When charging an iPhone on the top and an Android phone on the bottom, the total power can reach 33 watts. Keep the iPhone unchanged and replace the Samsung phone with AirPods. The total power becomes to close to 24 watts. Finally, we use the MagSafe module to fully charge the iPhone 14 Pro. The charging stand can charge it up to 41% in half an hour, and it can reach 76% in an hour, and 100% in 1 hour and 52 minutes, which is close to the wall charging of 1 hour and 40 minutes. Well, that's all tests we made for this ZIKE MagSafe wireless charging stand. You can charge two devices at the same time with a total power above 30 watts. And because of the powerful active cooling system, the heat generated by charging can theoretically be dissipated quickly. So the wireless charging speed can be comparable to wired charging. Okay, that's all for today's video. You can click the corners to see other MagSafe related products. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye!